Congrats on this show. This show is very unique. This is like half a superhero show, half a sci-fi show. Would you say that's accurate?
Yeah, it's kind of psychedelic, psychological.
It is.
Psycho styles.
It's a lot of psycho stuff in it. It's sort of from the X-Men universe. Dan Steven plays Professor Xavier's son.
That's right.
And you play Lenny. And Lenny's a pretty interesting cat. How would you describe Lenny?
Lenny Busker is the name, and it's really hard to describe without giving away the entire plot of the show, which I'm not allowed to do.
But we can say, can we say what happened to your character? Because you're still on the show, but...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's allowed, right?
Yes.
Yeah, because you died.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But...
Just watch and see. I don't know how to talk
about
it.
Well, you're still on the show.
I'm on the show, and my character does die in the first episode. But then I keep coming back, and something's not quite right. And you're like, what is going on with this?
I would say the first thing that's not right is when a dead person keeps coming back. That's usually a red flag.
Not to Lenny.
To Lenny, it's just a normal thing.
She's got a plan.
And was Cornflakes the middle name in the script?
Yeah, Cornflakes was the middle name in the pilot script, but that hasn't really paid off, and I don't think it ever will.
Gotcha, but you used it as inspiration.
In my own mind.
To prepare for the character of Lenny Cornflakes, what was the last name?
Busker.
Lenny Cornflakes Busker. It's a great name.
Yeah, it's like a stripper name.
A stripper name.
I would not.
If I was in a strip club and they said, up next, Lenny Cornflakes Busker, I'd be like, I'm going to go get a drink.
I'd be like pulling cornflakes out of my vagina. Like, take a couple of these.
You guys like fiber?
Yeah. I live on the street.
But did you use your cornflakes as inspiration?
Yeah, I use my cornflakes. In a lot of ways.
Yeah.
I had a lot of inspirations for the character. David Bowie was one of them.
That makes sense from what I've seen.
The character was originally written as a middle-aged man in the pilot script, and then when I came on board, it changed because...
Yeah.
And then, but the lines didn't change, so the gender changed, but not the dialogue, so I kind of...
That's really cool. What an interesting casting process that they would go so far afield of how it was written.
That's Noah Hawley.
Yeah.
He's a really interesting guy, and he makes really cool choices, I think.
Noah Hawley created the show. He also created Fargo, great FX series. He's a great author.
And an identical twin.
Does he really have an identical twin?
I think so.
Okay.
I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't have said that.
Yeah.
It's a secret.
Oh, God. So not only does your show have spoilers.
His twin is evil. I think he's identical. I don't know if it's identical or fraternal, actually, so don't quote me on that.
Okay. I'm going to do a long interview about Noah Hawley's twin after this.
Well, the thing about I don't know anything about it at all.
But the first episode, I watched the first episode twice of the show because it is, it's very... complicated seems negative, but I would say it's intricate.
No, I think, the show, it's great that it's on the air. It'll be, I think, even more fun for people that have missed it and that will end up binge-watching it because it's such a complicated show. It has many layers, and it's trippy, man. So gotta just...
Were you confused? When you read the script the first time, was it hard to follow?
Yes, I've read it. I had to read it so many times, even when I was shooting it. I read it over and over again because I was like, I am not smart enough to be in this show. Everyone else is smart except for me. So I had to really read it and really go, yeah, I get what's happening.
Dan Stevens, who is your co-star, great actor from Downton Abbey. We knew him from that. And is it true that you have, because everybody must be confused by the scripts, but you try to tell him that you know more than he does?
Well, yes, I did. Because my character is appearing to him in the show. And his character, the premise is that he's schizophrenic and he's in a mental hospital and he thinks he's crazy, but really he has superpowers. So he never knows what's real or not. So when we weren't shooting, and I'd always be like, Dan, that this character is going to end up doing this to you. And he'd be like, are you serious? No one told me that. And I'd be like, oh, yes. And I wouldn't know anything. And I would just constantly mess with him, like, all day long. And for me, I felt like it was my job to do that.
Oh, yeah. That's where...
just psychologically kind of...
That's what cornflakes does.
Yeah, that's typical cornflakes. Spreading your cornflakes all over the place. Just if making you... a real mess.